Welcome to the class of editorial decode, and in today's class I will be decoding a return to social science. This editorial is written by Shiv Vishwanathan. From examination point of view, it is important for the public administration students, for political science optional students, for sociology optional students, and important for general studies mains examination paper 2. Now, it is a kind of editorial that is different from the general league. It is a kind of editorial in which the author has tried to focus upon the critical importance of the social science. Before I discuss about the editorial decode, I just want to focus upon the importance of the discourses in social sciences. The discussions in social sciences, about the debates in social sciences, about the critical analysis in social sciences, and how this critical analysis is actually carried out in the social sciences. पहले हमें वो discuss करना है कि social sciences में critical analysis कैसे होता है, discussions किस तरह होती हैं, debates किस तरह होती हैं, and what is their relevancy with respect to the development of a country. And what is their relevancy with respect to the emancipation of the social thought? Now, let me tell you about something that is related to the link between the public policy and the discourses on the social sciences. The most important thing in the polity is the public policy. Now, what is public policy? Public policy is the policy that is formed by the government, that tells about the path, that tells about the direction, that tells about the movement, that tells about in which way the country is going to move. And this public policy, it contains numerous concepts, it contains ideologies, it contains vision, it contains spirit. So this public policy, it in itself is imbibing lot many things. And how this public policy is formed? This public policy is formed by the parliament, by the government, and by the various state institutions. All these organizations and institutions, they amalgamate, and their amalgamation, their thought results in the formation of public policy. But the public policy also derives its support from the discourses, from the discussions, from the debates, from the challenges, from the critical analysis that is done in the social circle of the society, from the discussions, from the debates, from the critical analysis that is done by the universities, by the professors of the universities, the discussions, the debates that is done by the sociologists, the analysis who analyzes the election results, the debates, the discussions that is done by the NGOs, civil societal organizations, that basically deals with the analysis of political realm, that basically deals with the analysis of political regime. But according to the author Shiv Vishwanathan, there has been a decline, there has been an erosion in the way the discussion, the discourses, they are carried out. These discussions, these discourses, these debates, these challenges, it leads to the paradigm change in the thought. It leads to the regeneration, it leads to the revival, it leads to the transformation, it leads to the creation of new thinking. By giving an example of the political theorist Rajni Kothari, he has tried to emphasize how the group that was established by Rajni Kothari has put up a challenge to the government. How the group of Rajni Kothari has focused upon the discourses that are related to development, that are related to human rights, that are related to the way the economy is being carried out. Hamari economy kis tarah carry out ho rahi thi? Before 1970s, 1980s, our economy was entirely focused on the concept of socialism. And before that, there was a lot of inclination towards Marxism. But this was the group of Rajni Kothari. There was a political discourse that was being carried out in our country that led to the strengthening of a parallel stream of thought. Another thought was put forward in the form of capitalism. So according to Shiv Vishwanathan, what he is trying to focus upon here is that indirectly, explicitly, it is not mentioned in the editorial, but implicitly he is trying to focus on the importance upon the role of the NGOs, upon the role of the civil societal organizations, of how they should be playing the role by conducting discourses, discussions, debates, etc. on the issues of development, on the issues of women emancipation, on the issue of child development, on the issue of eradicating corruption, on the issue of how the country should be carried forward, on the issue of environmental degradation. So what, according to the author, is that there has been a decline in all these things. We are actually failing to create an intellectual resource. When I was a student in university, there was n number of debates that were going on the issues of patent, on the issues of WTO, on the issues of human rights, and I have attended n number of seminars, and a critical resource was generated out of those seminars. A critical resource was created out of the debates that was conducted, and in that thing we are lacking. According to Shiv Vishwanathan, but according to me, there has been a phenomenal rise in the way these are conducted. There has been a stupendous rise in the NGOs. There has been a stupendous phenomenal rise of the organizations that are discussing developmental issues, that are discussing the social sciences issues. But because of the increase in the number, there has not been an increase in the number of ears. The ears, they remain the same, but the debates, they have increased. And because of that, we feel as if the debates, the discussions that are done by the intelligentsia of the society, there has been a decline in it. So it is a very, very important editorial, very well written editorial. So this was all for the decode of the day. Let me emphasize one more, another important aspect before I end this. These discussions, discourses are very, very important. They help in transforming the public policy. They help in transforming the views that the people hold about a particular policy. So kisi bhi concept ka in-depth analysis karna, usme badlaav leke aana, usme change leke aana, ek intelligentsia ka bahut bada haath hai. So this was all for the decode. You can subscribe to my channel. Name of my channel is EIEAS Mentors. You can contact me at 84594-0000 in case you are interested in buying my video classes on the entire civil services preparation. And to avail further information on the classes that I'm offering, you can visit my website eiasmentors.com and brainiki.com. And please install my application, Android application from Google Play Store. The name of the application is Brainiki. Very soon we'll be launching iPhone and iPads application. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.